Good morning, children. I hope that you all are keeping well, safe and sound back at your homes. And today I am here for your online lesson for English literature. And I know that you know me well, but I hope that you are able to recognize me. That is because of the beards and moustaches that have grown on me, but don't be scared. This is just a simple effect of this worldwide lockdown. So I welcome you to this online lesson for English literature phase 2. So let us begin our class for today, and let us shift the focus from my beards to this board. And here you will see that we are going to start today the phase 2 of English literature, and today we are going to deal and discuss with the chapter Old Man at the Bridge, written by Ernest Miller Hemingway. Now what I am going to do in this phase and this part of your lesson is that I am going to present you 3 short videos, and in the first video I will be telling you, discussing with you about the introduction, background and summary of the short story. In the second video, I will be discussing with the story, details and aspects associated with it. And in the third video, I will be telling you about the symbols and images that have been incorporated in this short story. So let us begin our class for today, and this is the beginning of the video 1, where I will be taking up the introduction, background and summary of the short story Old Man at the Bridge. Now this story Old Man at the Bridge is centered upon or set in the backdrop of the Spanish Civil War that was fought between 1936 and 1939. You can see here the Spanish Civil War. And this short story written by Ernest Hemingway deals on the backdrop of war. Sources say that this short story was first published in the Ken magazine for the first time. Ken magazine on May 19, 1938. Now what we see here is that this Old Man at the Bridge, now 2 very key points are very important here. First is Old Man and the second is Bridge. So you can well understand, you can apprehend that there is an old man in the story and he is somewhere, somewhat, somehow at the bridge. And that is what this story revolves around. Why such a theme and topic is taken up by Hemingway is because Hemingway was very, very closely associated with war. Which war? The Second World War. During the time of Second World War, Ernest Hemingway served as a correspondent in 1941. Correspondent is who brings out the details, the news, the reports concerning to the war. And therefore, he had seen war very closely. And it is this aspect, his touch, his acquaintances with the events of a war, that he takes up such a theme for dealing with the story Old Man at the Bridge. So here in the backdrop of the second of this Spanish Civil War, we find a bridge that is built across the Ebro River. The entire story focuses around Spain, where one side of the bridge we have San Carlos and the other side we have the cities of Barcelona and Tortosa. Let us come to the story. Here from San Carlos there has been an old man who happened to walk a distance of 12 kilometers, and he reached to this bridge.
Tired, exhausted, driven by fatigue, the old man gives up his hope and he sits to rest on the bridge. Meanwhile, there is a young soldier who is the narrator himself, whose duty was to cross the bridge and see how far had the enemy advanced. I'll come back to the word enemy later on. But now, here, this soldier, his duty was to see how far the enemy had advanced. And while he was on his way to the other side of the bridge, he saw the old man sitting here. On his return, this young soldier, the narrator, found that the old man was still sitting on the bridge. Aroused by curiosity, the soldier begins to ask the whereabouts of the old man. And this conversation between this soldier and the old man happens to be the bottom line of the story, Old Man at the Bridge. Now, coming back to the word enemy. Here, San Carlos depended or was guided by liberal democracy. Liberal democracy. And referring to the word enemy, we come to the word fascists. Fascists who were ruled or guided by, headed by Francisco, F-R-A-N-C-I-S-C-O. I hope the spelling is right. Still, please check. Francisco Franco, aided by, helped by dictators like Hitler and Mussolini. It is this fascist troop which happened to come to conquer San Carlos. And it is this fascism that was spreading very fast in the early 20th century. And this soldier, his duty was to find out how far these enemy troops had advanced. And it is this duty that brings him to the other side of the bridge. The background of the story therefore revolves around the Spanish Civil War, where this fascist group come to conquer San Carlos, thereby defeating liberal democracy. And in this defeat, in this horror of war, in this pointlessness of war, we come across the story, Old Man at the Bridge. So here, this old man had walked from San Carlos. Why so? Because he was driven out from this town on account of artillery attack. What is artillery attack? It is attack by air or any other means in which the common people are severely damaged, destroyed, and killed. He was therefore forced to leave the town and travel the distance of 12 kilometers to reach to this bridge on the Ebro River. He was the last man to leave the town. Why so? That I will tell you, that we will discuss when we come to video 2. But here, it is this conversation between the soldier and the old man which brings to us the theme, the backline, the backdrop, the point of the story, the old man at the bridge. So this is the introduction, the background. In background, you need to remember the Spanish Civil War, 1936-39, first published in May 1938, and this event of the conversation between the narrator and the old man happens in 1938, which forms our basis for this short story. So in this video, I hope you understand the introduction, background and summary of the story Old Man at the Bridge. We will move to video 2, where I will discuss with you the story, the details and the different aspects associated with this. Thank you for watching this video. You can click to the video 2 to read, to know about the story in very details. Thank you.